Uncle, sure, you see that auntie. Her name is Auntie Stella. She has money, eh? Hey!
Who told you she has money?
Sure, you can't see her car. See, sure, you see that fine house after that place that Aboki that used to wear long short knicker has a shop. Me, I even hear that she's the one that owns the house, so she did not rent it.
Good for her.
Ah, Uncle, don't say that, too. That is what they call hammer. Uncle, we too, we have to hammer, oh.
Hammer in what way?
To make money, now, so that we will have that kind of big house. And somebody will move away from this Pangolo house and go to a better one. That your Tweke car self, we will buy a bigger one like that her own.
So your problem is her big house and her big car?
Yes, now.
Not the fact that your big head cannot occupy enough wisdom to equate with its size.
Uncle, forget that thing. That is what they call emancipation of oblong matters with a maximum equilateral memory.
Which memory? Do you have any memory?
Uncle, forget that thing. Have you not heard the saying that the shortest pen is better than the longest memory? This day, Seth, we have a new saying. The shortest bank account is better than the highest degree. Sure, you want to end up like those professors that used to read the books in the whole world and end up with a tortoise car like that grandpa's own. Sure, you see the small house that grandpa built and his small tortoise dilapidated and outdated car with the frustrated abandonment.
If he hears you, you won't eat for the next 3 days. Better mind your words. It's not all about what anyone has to tackle. It's about being contented with what you have. That my car might not be a big car. It's not flashy. Our house is an old house and everything. My dear, go to Ojuelagba under bridge in Suleri. There are people that are sleeping inside commercial buses. Some sleep under the bridge with no covering over their heads.
Uncle, that is called midnight extravaganza of the homeless catastrophe.
So you think that's the life that you want to live?
Uncle, you know the conductors and bus drivers normally don't have a sleeping time now. They can work 24 hours in a day. So anywhere that sleep catches them, they will dispatch the passengers and park their bus and sleep.
That's not true, my dear. No human being hates comfort and security. But when people sleep wherever they see, in an open space and all of that, it's a sign of hopelessness, meaning they have no choice. Can you sleep even outside this compound till the next morning?
Ah, Uncle, for what now? Sure, 2 weeks ago you did not hear guns in the midnight that they said that some people were robbing in that street behind us. You want me to sleep outside? Uncle, that is unthinkable. It is a plagiarization of insecurity in aggregational calamity with a suffocation of calamitous innuendo. Don't even think about it.
You see, which means you value your life. Those people who sleep under the bridge have no choice. The only thing that secures them is God. So we are better than them, even though we are not up to the level of Antistella. So it will be good if you don't envy others for what they have. Because no matter our condition, there are those we are still better than.
Ah! But Uncle, that Antistella car, eh? It is one in town, 2 in city, 3 in mega city, 4 in...
There was a time ceiling sheets were used for mansions while other people couldn't even afford ceilings in their house. But as of today, the modern ceiling is now POP. No more ceiling boards. That are cars that is the talk of town today. 5 years from now, it will be outdated. That are mansion that is glamorous and expensive. In the next 10 years or even less, people won't build those kind of houses anymore.
Why?
Because they will be obsolete.
Like to solotape up of the house?
How?
You said obsolete, na? Sure, it is like solotape, na? Abi is not the shortcut of solotape that you mean.
Obsolete simply means out of fashion, dummy. There was a time limousine was the happening car. Today, people that own limousine only park it at their backyard for historic purposes. There was a time Hummer was the talk of town. Today, you hardly see one Hummer vehicle on the street, even in a whole month. If you watch Nollywood movies that were acted 10 years back, the houses and cars that the big boys then were using is what we call old school today.
That is true, Uncle. I was watching one movie yesterday called World Apart. And Edo was in that movie. Hey, Uncle, everything in that movie is old school. The cars in the movies were all those Paco Mercedes 190.
Thank you. But do you know that those Mercedes 190 in that movie were the hot cars of that time. Go and listen to Nigerian music of 15 years back. If you play them in parties today, people will be looking at you like, duh. But in those days, they were our anthems.
That is true. Shey, they say that music, what is it called? You don't hit my car or you break better.
That is Tony the Thriller.
Uh-huh.
Nobody plays that music anymore. And even the artist himself is nowhere to be found. Those were the days of Idris Abdul Karim, the likes of Style Plus, this other guy, SN Freestyle, the guy that featured Two-Face in Sip Easy. That song, Sip Easy, plenty lighter for here,
hey,
plenty shy for here, plenty chicks there, no steel man, and even Two-Face himself, they were plantation boys then. The other two guys, Face and Blackface, have phased out. So you see, my dear, nothing actually lasts forever. What is up today might be down tomorrow, and what is down today might be up tomorrow. So don't envy what others have. Instead, work hard to achieve your own. Our destinies are not the same. Same way our purpose on earth. One person's purpose might be to be a lawyer, while the other person's might be to be a drummer. People die at a young age, some die at average age, and some people die at old age. People have different purposes. Even Jesus Christ himself didn't live up to 45, because his purpose on earth was complete. So envying others is like using someone else's ID card. But most of all, be happy for what you have and be happy for what others have. It will make you live a life of less stress and little to worry about.
Uncle, so what of those people that I get mad? Is that one too a purpose?
It might be a purpose too. There was a time you were born and was a baby. There was a time you could only take milk. There's a time you have to go to primary school, secondary school, tertiary. Those are stages in your life and they are part in your purpose. A cleaner today might become a business owner tomorrow. The purpose of that cleaner might just be to gather experience so that they can set up their own firm tomorrow. I have seen a security operative that end up setting up his own security firm. He is a boss today. So at whatever level of a person's life, it might be his or her purpose at that time in life.
Uncle, but that man that is living opposite there that used to do Okada, he is old now. When will he start owning his own Okada company?
Don't get me wrong, I am not saying everybody must climb to the top of the ladder in life. There's a tendency that if you don't work hard or you are scared of taking some steps in life, you might remain where you are till you get old. Not everyone lives their purpose in life, because I am not sure that God created some people to be beggars while he created others to be bosses. Sometimes the decisions of parents might affect the future of their children and even themselves. But even Jesus Christ himself said, you will always have beggars amongst you.
Ah, Uncle, that is infringement of fundamental human and personal prerogative with the spiritual entitlement. So you are saying God created some people to be poor?
I never said God created anyone to be poor and the other one to be rich. I've explained that already. The point is, don't walk with the fear for what you don't have, but with the joy for what you have. Because that which you hope to have today will become old and archaic tomorrow.
Just like Grandpa now. He should be happy that he can sleep, not be unhappy that he can snore.
What did you say?
Hey! Ah, Grandpa, you are not sleeping.
Come to this place now.
Okay, I am out of here.
Oh yeah, come here now.
Hey, this is one chance, oh.